Okay, what is happening to you, sister?
I'm having problem inside my stomach.
I can't hear you.
I'm having problem inside my stomach, and the doctors, they say they can't see anything.
Can you move? Can you move, sister? My sister. This is a cyst. You know cyst?
Yes, I was thinking it's ovarian cyst, but when they checked, they said they are not seeing anything.
You say what?
I was thinking it's ovarian cyst, yes. But they are saying they are not seeing anything.
It's a cyst. It's a cyst. 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 It's an attack in the cyst. It's a spiritual thing. Move. Show me how you move. That's how you move. You feel pain.
I feel pain.
So you were thinking it's a cyst.
Yes, I was thinking it's a cyst.
Doctor want to operate you and they don't trust that.
Yeah, it's what they said because I have to go back in February at the hospital.
They say what?
They said I have to come back in February because they put me through so many machines, but they are saying they
You'll
can't
You'll be operated
anything.
And it will be very bad for you. They want to kill you.
Okay.
In Jesus' name. Someone told you to come for prayer.
Yes.
Why you didn't come?
I was not managing to walk properly, and I was not having money for transport.
But someone told you, come for prayer.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
And then you say what?
I said I don't have money and I'm not working properly.
That's what you said?
Yes. And now I asked somebody to help me with giving me a lift to come today.
You know this issue of divorce.
Yes.
It's a very serious issue.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
It's a very serious issue. This can be, I don't know. You might, it's a, this, is it a court case or what?
Yes, it is.
Huh?
It is. It's a divorce and a court case.
And a court case also.
Yes.
So it's a very, that's why you are going through all this. I want to kill you because of this issue. I set you free today.
Amen.
And when God set you free,
amen.
You have, go back to what you are normally doing.
Okay, amen.
You understand?
Amen.
Go back, because the devil wants to stop everything, he wants to stop you, so that you must not even do what you are doing.
Yes, of course, I stopped since I'm not working properly. I have customers now, I can't sit on the machine.
That's why I say, go back to what you were doing. Look here. Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Out. Out. Look at her face now. Out. God is healing you. Out. Out. Can you put a mic in her mouth here the way she's feeling pain?
Oh.
Out! God is healing her. Out! Jesus' name. You are free now.
Amen.
Can you walk? Come back. Walk faster. How do you feel?
I'm feeling fine now. Even my waist is fine. Everything is fine.
Everything?
Yes.
Can you beach? You don't feel anything?
Nothing.
Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
My sister, this was supposed to result in operation.
Yes, this is the way they were saying, because they were talking about, they think maybe it's a cancer of a large intestine or an ulcer on the large intestine.
So you are free. Let's get another one. Let me hear.
Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Ndoima panda ndio mzimu ndikodolibwa mzimu.
I'm standing in front of all of you to thank God.
Zwe mzimu banyita rati diburu ndingazwita ruchedisa hani.
What God has done for me, I don't know how to explain it.
Ndowana deliverance yanganga Wednesday.
I got my deliverance on Wednesday.
Everything's otomanga May.
Everything started in May.
Sototoma ipaini thuku ye yabai kundina kunduni.
It was just a small pain that was troubling me on my waist.
And then zichitoma afuwa tomo vam, ndatomo vama denga pama funga pasi manji e abakova tamen again ustonga ndizulandishko barero di fara.
And from there, water would come out of my private all the time.
Jesu askonkoso ndi diwane ndikoshimisa pedze ngori ndaniga skono zulandisinayo obakova amanji renda ndichidwana ndotab.
All the time water would come out a lot to extent that I ended up using pads.
And akwamabo Malihodi vambo diamba na mama ndadanda bonana na mama.
I found Pastor Malihodi, she referred me to mommy. I came and I spoke with mommy.
Mama banrabela barandovo forowa.
Mama prayed for me and she said I'm delivered.
Madi astopa but pain yoba isongo stopa.
The water started, stopped coming out, but the pain didn't stop.
All the time, I
would come for prayer, Pastor Lucy and Mommy would always pray for me.
October,
on the week of my birthday, things became worse. I couldn't do anything anymore. It would worsen in the evening.
Pain yoba ichirun toma ndavandi uchwana ndisa diburu nditemini ndito gwadama ndichimbire ndilale fast ndovandi sadiburu nditemini ndovandi koita zvimwe zvitu zvine abana baba vako dibudziso ruko itea mini.
When the pain started or when it starts, I would get confused myself. I wouldn't even know what to do, and the kids would also be confused.
Ndovandi sadiburu kofe at all.
I couldn't even sleep at night.
When evening came,
I would have a great problem. Instead of sleeping in the evening, I will be exercising when others are asleep, and it will cause me to be always eating all the time, because without eating, I would feel like there's something that is eating me up in my stomach.
December, she told my brothers about worse.
When December started, my situation became worse.
Nobody's chakona no chimbira.
I couldn't walk anymore.
And then that is chapa tasty, chituna chiti, chachiliwa.
I couldn't even have a taste of food.
Nobody's chakona toilet at all.
I couldn't even go to the bathroom.
I ran this walk a distance, a tukutuku tumbiangobe, she kukumanda tonga, and 6 months pregnant.
If I would walk a little distance, my stomach would swell up like I am 6 months pregnant.
And then again, which spring a pain is but the worst and gandrene, little guadama fastendary cover and one dear fanoning at the face.
At that point, we're trying to walk, my pain will become worse to the point where I would just have to lie down and ask my kids to massage my back. It was an everyday thing for my children. They would change. When their hands would get tired, I would ask them to use their legs to kick me at the back. My situation worsened. I went to the clinic, they referred me to the hospital.
Johannesburg Hospital,
I went to Johannesburg Hospital a lot of time. They would check me, they wouldn't know what's wrong with me.
Problem ya ovary, but what she said baba sakowana shit.
I would feel in me that I have a problem with my ovaries, but when they check, they wouldn't find anything.
Zitu zombo diba we serwe na uvas baderandi chibu yanduni, doba ndi shakona noto vangangomu kamara, nuriduane ndikudzura sitting room.
Things escalated to the point where when I was discharged from the hospital, coming back home, for me to come out of my bedroom, it was now a problem. I would stay there and sleep all the time.
And the musundi chise zabana vanga, doba ndi chifila pain, ngangomu wangangomu, ndani kuzifori, awicha na buchiro kane.
Each time I look at my kids, I would feel pain in my heart because I would feel in me that there is no more life.
And hoyu mutuku musi achotamba, obachotamba 5 minutes abuya back. Achimeka sure kuti nanure abone ndika difemana kana ndi rightina.
The little one, the last one, when he goes to play, he will go and play for 5 minutes, come back to check on me whether I'm still breathing. And I was failing to get a chance to come to church. Because where I get taxis is quite a distance because I couldn't walk. And there were servants of God who were continuing to encourage me to come to the house of God, but I couldn't because I couldn't walk.
And last week, Last week,
I had a dream and I saw myself in the midst of all my relatives that have already passed away. When I woke up in the morning, I couldn't do anything anymore. Even the medication was no longer working. I was just vomiting out. I couldn't feel life in me anymore. On Wednesday, I was able to call somebody who is a member here to bring me to church. I thank God because when I came, I got my deliverance. After Daddy prayed for me, I was now able to walk. When I went home, my kids were very happy. We were all excited. We ended up crying because I saw that they now had stress because of my condition.
I even forgot how you smiled.
Oh, the young one, Andabele Sarmaundo, I want to say sad.
But I told you that if you can go to church, Daddy or Mommy will pray for you and you'll be fine.
My child will come and lay his hands on my stomach and pray for me because as a child, he didn't know how to help me to bring me to church. I thank God for giving me another chance of life. From Wednesday, I am now able to sleep. On Wednesday, when I was asleep, I saw a big giant in front of me. He was holding a sword. I found myself being able to take the sword from the giant and I cut it into pieces and put them aside. When I woke up, I prayed, I said, God, I have overcame because of you. I thank God because I'm still alive. Amen.